JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for February the 23rd. I am Haralambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It lost the most ground versus JPY, AUD, GBP and the euro in that order, while it gained slightly only versus NOK. The strengthening of the Japanese yen suggests that markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia, but the strengthening of the Aussie points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices closed their trading in the red, with the only exception being the Dow Jones Industrial Average, which gained fractionally. The negative investor morale rolled somewhat over into the Asian session today as well. Although Hong Kong's Hang Seng gained 1.10%, China, Shanghai Composite and South Korea's KOSPI slid 0.17 and 0.31% respectively. Japanese markets stayed closed in celebration of the Emperor's birthday. Now, equity slid perhaps as rising inflation expectations continued driving government bond yields to the upside. Since the beginning of February, US 10-year Treasury yields have risen approximately 28 basis points, headed for the largest monthly gain in 3 years. As for the US dollar, it failed to capitalize on the rising yields environment, perhaps as its traders stayed cautious ahead of Fed Chair Powell's semi-annual testimony before Congress today and tomorrow. In our view, rising yields suggest that there is some sort of speculation that major central banks may begin normalizing monetary policy soon. So with that in mind, investors may lock their gaze on Powell's testimony before the Senate Banking Committee today, looking for clues as to when the Fed is considering to begin scaling back its QE purchases. However, we don't expect Powell to add fuel to tapering expectations. At the press conference following the latest FOMC decision, he clearly stated that it's too early to focus on tapering dates, while in a more recent speech, he stayed on the dovish side. He noted that the improvement in the labor market has stalled in recent months, and even if we do see a strong labor market soon, they will not tighten monetary policy solely in response to that. He affirmed that they will keep interest rates at current levels until the economy has reached maximum employment and inflation stayed above 2% for some time, something that, according to the minutes of the latest meeting, is expected to happen in the years after 2023. Therefore, a reiteration of his dovish stance may be the base case scenario, and thus if this is the case, we are unlikely to see a huge market reaction. Equities may trade somewhat higher, while the dollar is likely to slip slightly. The risk to this event is for Powell to sound more hawkish and start hinting when tapering may start. This is likely to trigger a tumble in equities and a strong rebound in the US dollar. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK employment data for December. The unemployment rate ticked up to 5.1 from 5% as expected, while the employment change revealed a 114,000 job loss. The forecast was for the economy to have lost 30,000 jobs. That said, following last week's better than expected CPI data for January, this is unlikely to add to speculation for more easing by the Bank of England. At its latest gathering, the Bank of England pushed back the idea of negative interest rates, which combined with the fact that the UK is going further ahead with the COVID vaccination rate race, encouraged the GBP traders to buy more of the British currency. In our view, the same catalysts are likely to continue supporting the pound. We also get the Eurozone's final CPIs for January, which are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates, as well as the US Conference Board Consumer Confidence Index for February, which is forecast to have risen to 90 from 89.3. The American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week is also coming out, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. As for tonight, during the Asian session Wednesday, the RBNZ decides on monetary policy. Back in November, this bank decided to keep its official cash rate and its large-scale asset purchase program unchanged, with Governor Andrea North saying that domestic activity since August has been more resilient than previously assumed. Quarter 4 inflation stayed unchanged at 1.4% year-over-year within the bank's target range of 1-3%, while the employment data for the quarter showed that the unemployment rate dropped to 4.9% from 5.3% and that the employment change rebounded 0.6% quarter over quarter after falling 0.8% in the third quarter. Now, our view, this data diminishes further the probability for negative interest rates, and it even increases the chances for policymakers to sound more sanguine than they did in November. A more optimistic language is likely to prove positive for the Kiwi, which we also expect to stay supported by an improved broader market sentiment. As for the speakers, besides Fed Chair Powell and RBNZ Governor Andrea North, we also have Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem on the agenda. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.